first ever song, Gym Tear Laundry. Let's go. All in up, we're living the dream. Gym Tan Laundry, just like the classic golden era bodybuilder days, man.
Look at that motherfucker surfing out there.
Look at him. That's the life. We living life right now. This is what life's all about. Flowing down, taking it all in. Pause. But just like, you know, being with the homies and enjoying the day, getting some sun, and then handling business, bro.
Chest day
today. It's gonna go crazy, bro. Jizzy's not here. Sam's not here. He said he was feeling sick. He's had like a head cold for a few days. He couldn't beat it this morning, so he's gonna stay home. But we're gonna do a crazy chest day.
Yeah, it's gonna go crazy.
Oh yeah, he gonna split the ocean. He gonna split the seas.
Look at that ocean. Come on, dude.
All right, that's good. That's good.
I think a little bit more.
Yeah, a little bit more. No, man. Want to say hi to YouTube? You guys are on YouTube right
now. Yeah.
Say what's up.
It's good with you.
You see that oil? It's good to meet you guys.
Give a little explanation though.
Of what?
Of what just happened.
Of what just happened? Dude. Okay, so I asked these guys, I'm like, yo, is it weird if you ask a girl to rub oil on your back on the beach? They're like, you only see this shit in movies. You know what I mean? I've never personally done it. They've never done it. So I just attempted that with a female. Yeah, what's up? Dude, let's go. Beach snack.
Yes, sir, bro.
Appreciate it, man.
Let's go.
Right. Yo, completely failed. She said, you're all right. And I realized that I'm fucked. So I went over to the boys because I knew they weren't going to let me down. And they didn't, bro. You need to get oil up on the beach. Ask your homeboy. He'll do it for you.
And they barely rubbed that shit in, bro. It's just like,
it's just breathing. Bro, yeah.
You look like a glazed donut.
Sauteed bodybuilder right now, man. All right, ladies and gentlemen, first episode of Gym Tan Laundry. You guys just saw the beach part, the tan part. This is also prepping for my shows coming up this summer. I take the gym real seriously, so this is gonna be your personalized dialing from Shizzy. And my brother's not here, he's not feeling well. So this is gonna be a chest day. We're gonna be laser damn, man, super focused. I'm not gonna waste your guys' time. I mean, I'm just gonna do my top three exercises for my chest. Hopefully it helps you guys grow too. And we're just gonna get straight into it, guys. Come on, let's go. So normally when I first like get to the gym, your day has like so many different emotions and so much stuff that goes on. It's like really important that you stay locked in mentally. So like I started doing cardio just to help me like lock in. Like I don't even do this really just to, I'm warming up my muscles and my body, but it really helps me like dial in on my workout, my mindset, not coming in here to play games, just coming in here. Right now I'm thinking about my exercises. I'm thinking about what I got to do to grow, how much food I had today, going over everything I did before I hit the workout, just so like I'm so dialed in that I have nothing else I have that's going to come up and distract me from my workout. Bro, if you can get in here for an hour every day, leave everything at home and put everything on the gym floor every time, like you're gonna make progress. We're all in here to get a physique, but the guy that puts his phone down, the guy that has his head down and works in the gym is gonna get that physique faster than the guy who goes in there for social reasons or goes in there for, you know, just to dick around. So take this time seriously while you're in the gym and take the time while you're on your cardio machines just to really lock in mentally before your workout. I apologize to you guys too that I haven't been giving it my all on this channel. I haven't really been pushing myself because I was honestly scared that people are gonna take my words out of context and use them. That being said, I owe it to you guys. This whole series is gonna be 100% raw energy. Hopefully you guys from this series gain some knowledge and gain some inspiration, guys, because this is something I'm really passionate about and I really wanna fucking win, man. So we're gonna put that work in on this workout right here because this every workout fucking counts. So we're gonna make this bitch count, bro. Come on.
Oh.
saw we went 2 to 3. Now we're back to 2.5. 3 felt heavy. My mindset is just, I want to push blood into my muscle right now. I already hit it with 3 plates. I got to get some good stretches on it. We got 2 more exercises after this, so I want to take advantage and try to just pump it full of blood before I get on to the next exercise. Best pump, the best sweat comes after the beach.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm so glad that you think the same thing.
Yeah.
I thought it was just me.
Sitting there, before we even got here, I was already sweating. So I know my body's already ready
to
go.
Yeah.
It feels good.
Hell yeah. And it's like a little bit of that tan. You look good in, good in the mirror too.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Still couldn't get any oil on my back though, you know what I mean? This shit lined up is like trying to fucking figure out how many forms are in pie. Bench press variation. I got this one from Jay Cutler, actually, and actually Arnold too. Reason why I do a lot of incline bench is because I feel, my personally, in a physique, I really admire a big upper chest. My lower chest is naturally like just developed, so I never really had to do declines. But nah, man, the incline bench is one of the best exercises to grow a chest in general. They might hit me for this, but I don't care. When I bench press and shit, I'll switch the grip. So at first I'll start my normal regular bench press hand position, which is about shoulder width. But towards the end of this exercise, I'll start to creep my hands out further just so I can get this way bigger stretch right there. But it's important not to put a lot of weight on the bar if you're doing a really wide bench press like that, because you could really mess up your shoulder.
Centimeters of, of crushing your chin.
Yeah.
You keep it all the way up there on the top, huh?
I make it touch my face so that if I can't get it up, it'll crush my face. It definitely plays a trick on your mind. Like, you don't want to get hurt, so you have to get that shit off your chest. I do a lot of shit like that. I just don't fucking think about it, you know? Last set, I put 225 on, and then I do a drop set. That's what it should be every fucking set, bro. Last one, it's gotta be a stretch. But I think we're gonna do like a kind of a superset deal. I have a good idea. Hani taught me these chest press, I guess you would call this right here. Keep it in, keep your elbows tight. And then we're gonna go right into, from here, hit failure till we can't go. And then start hitting flies. We'll see how that feels. Yeah, but the side chest has come a long way.
I'm tucking my arm right underneath my ribcage right here.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So, it brings your chest up because you're automatically trying to squeeze it in if you're pushing the fuck out of this.
Oh,
you see that?
I see.
And this is up. It's arch your back. Boom.
Okay, you got that down, Pat. I gotta work on that.
Yo, I'm in there.
I see.
I'm in my ribs right there.
You can even see the lat.
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah. I feel like that's what Arnold did. He pulled it in.
And far back
so
enough.
You can see your lat.
To show off the serratus in the lat.
And your chest comes up. Guys, that was the fucking best chest day ever. And now we're gonna finish with some flies, because who doesn't like to finish with flies? But that's it, we don't hit arms on chest day. That's for shoulders and arms day, but three exercises like that, that's all you need. I'm only doing one set. Super intense like training video, right? Like not normally what we do, because Samuel and I have really like been talking about how we want to do a YouTube. Like, do we want to do more of like a lifestyle stuff, or do we want to do gym videos? You guys know Samuel's content, you know my content's very different. I love being in the gym. I love like the edits. I love the funk music. I love all that stuff. That's not his vibe. We're finally finding our balance where I'll do like a training video, a prep video, a beach tan laundry video, and then Samuel will do like a lifestyle videos. But we're gonna start doing two videos a week, guys. Really excited to be able to like be like solid enough and comfortable enough here in LA to finally start making like solid videos. It was really, really, really hard settling in here. Drew can even say he got here like a month ago. It's just tough mentally to live in LA. I mean, anyone who lives here can tell you that. With God and with family and with the support of other people and you guys like showing love and stuff, like really helped us ground ourselves and understand like why we make content again. Like, you guys rarely ever get to hear me talk like one-on-one with you guys, because it's usually me and my brother, and my brother's like, yo, shut up, you're yapping. But like, this is like the one in the videos I got to talk to you guys, and it's been really tough, man. Like, you know, Samuel, he moved in with me about 2 years ago. I've seen him grow so much in the last 2 years. I mean, it's so cool to see everything unfold before us, and we couldn't have done it without you guys. So I just want to say thank you for helping us with this transition. Thank you for always supporting us, watching our videos and stuff. Yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. That's like really what I want to give you guys. I want to give you guys me. I want to give you guys 100% me. To be honest, like when all that stuff went down like online, where people just like started hating on me and stuff, it really like bothered me, bro. Like, it bothered me like wanting to open up more. Like, I didn't want to open up and show people my personality because I didn't want people to tear me apart. And the internet is a really mean and tough, could be a tough place. And I'm finally comfortable enough to be like, I don't care what you guys think about me. It's just who I am, man. And this is how I train. And if you guys are inspired by it, then God bless you guys and power to you. Cause this is just what I've been doing, man. And I never would have thought I would be making content ever. And it's so cool like to be here in this position, and I'm extremely honored and blessed. So I take this stuff very seriously. I know you guys look up to me, and I take that very seriously as well. And I love you guys, just so you know. I don't know, it's like life is good, bro. I don't know why I've been feeling like that lately. It's just like, I think it's just a decision I've been making mentally. Like, why would you be upset? Like, why do I keep choosing to be sad and shit? Why not be happy? Like, why not choose to try to like be optimistic, and why not try to be different? So that's just what I've been doing, and it's working. Gorilla bar and protein.
Yes.
Blueberries, I got the chocolate, vanilla. Out of these three, bro, probably churro. Churro is probably my favorite, but blueberries definitely in second place. Definitely.
We got up there. We got up there.
Poor Jizzy don't feel good.
Guys, unfortunately, we actually have laundry on a beach day, laundry day.
So this is where I'll be. But check out these lighters that Harry's boy sent us. We call this house the doghouse, bro. We all got doghouse lighters. And guess what I'm going to do with this lighter? No, but seriously, guys, love you guys. That's it, dude. We'll catch you for another day at Gym Tan Laundry, episode 2, next week, baby. See you.